Hi, I'm Ron Dharma. On this video, I'm going to showcase Google Cloud Anthos that enable Google Kubernetes Engine on-prem with HPE SimpliVity. A couple of major benefits to the hybrid IT customers. One, seamless hybrid IT experience by using Google Cloud's development and operations of Google Kubernetes Engine on their on-prem site. Two, customers can also manage their virtual machines workload using the familiar SimpliVity tool. These are the components of the Google Kubernetes Engine on-prem. One, admin will log in via Linux admin workstation to perform the deployment and management of GKE on-prem. Two, admin clusters will host the admin control and user control planes for the communication with GCP, vCenter, worker nodes, and last but not least, the monitoring tools in GCP. Three, user clusters consist of worker nodes where the containers will be hosted and operational. Four, layer 4 network load balancer for the ingress and egress of control and applications networking. Five, the HPE SimpliVity cluster with VMware vSphere where the GKE on-prem is hosted. This is the vCenter admin view of the GKE on-prem that has been deployed on top of the HPE SimpliVity. In the resource pool GKE_RP, we can observe all of the components that are part of the Google's Cloud Anthos clusters. We can also view some of the VM workloads that run in the same SimpliVity cluster. SimpliVity functionality such as backups will still be applicable to each of these VM hosted in the SimpliVity data store. Moreover, admin can perform SimpliVity operations against legacy workload and hosting the cloud native workload. Let's take a look at the view of the Google's Cloud Platform dashboard, where the GKE on-prem cluster have been registered. Note that the Kubernetes admin also can manage the Google Cloud-hosted Kubernetes cluster in the same dashboard. Now, we were navigating into the applications that I've deployed on GKE on-prem, which is SimpliVity, which is the Google's Cloud Kubernetes version of WordPress. The WordPress is deployed together with MySQL database to host the WordPress website that has been adapted for this demo. So the demo showcased the GKE on-prem with SimpliVity to host the curated applications available in Google Marketplaces. In the next demo, I'm going to present the deployment of GKE on-prem with HPE SimpliVity. Admin will start by downloading the Linux Admin Station OVA from the designated Google repository. Google provides Terraform automation script to deploy this admin workstation. The admin workstation contains the pre-configured tools to deploy GKE on-prem. After the admin workstation have been deployed with the required keys, admin will log in into the admin workstation VM to start the GKE on-prem deployment. Admin will modify a config YAML with the information such as vCenters, credentials, GCP key files, among many other things. To ensure proper and faultless deployment, admin will perform the check config of the config YAML as shown here. The admin then performs the preparation prior to deployment of the GKE on-prem clusters by issuing the prepare and validate config. The preparation will download another OVA and make it as a VM template. Now, this template will be used as the base image for all the Kubernetes nodes, which is part of the GKE admin and user clusters as further shown in this demo. Now it's time to create the GKE on-prem cluster using the configuration file that have been validated. Note that this process would create the nodes that are part of the admin cluster and then followed by the nodes for the first user cluster. The first step in orchestration is deploying the admin cluster master. The orchestration also orchestrating the load balancer to allow the required traffic to be directed properly as being shown here. All of the nodes of the master cluster will also be deployed afterwards. The next steps in orchestration is to perform deployment of the user cluster master node, which is providing the control plane to the worker nodes part of the user cluster. And in about 22 minutes, we can see the user master cluster node was established. Afterward, the user cluster master node is fully functional, and we can see that worker nodes part of the first user cluster were deployed in parallel. While the worker nodes were being prepared for the orchestration, they're also setting up the communications required for GKE API, user cluster API, and service mesh that are part of the GKE on-prem. In about 29 minutes later, the deployment of user cluster nodes have completed, and this concludes the deployment of GKE on-prem to the HPE SimpliVity cluster. Now we are looking at the GCP console, and observe that deployed user cluster was automatically registered into the list of the cluster that is managed by this GCP account. To allow the GCP to manage GKE on-prem user cluster, I created authorization to allow the binding of the Kubernetes service account that will generate a special token. Copy this token into the GCP login to the cluster menu, and user cluster in GKE on-prem now can make use all of the services available in the GCP, including the deployment of the GCP Marketplace Kubernetes applications. Final demo, I will deploy the WordPress from the GCP Marketplace onto the GKE on-prem cluster hosted with HPE SimpliVity. In the GCP console, I click the button to deploy from the Google Marketplace. In the marketplace, I filter out the Kubernetes applications for block and content management service. Now, Google Anthos allow the deployment of WordPress from the GCP marketplace to the GKE on-prem hosted in the SimpliVity, similar to the deployment of the Google's public cloud. Now, to deploy the application, I select the Google Kubernetes cluster, which is hosted on-prem using the HPE SimpliVity. After selecting the new namespaces, I deploy these WordPress applications. The deployment continued, and within 30 seconds, we can see the pods that contains the components such as the SQL Server, authentication services, and many other services are spin up in the user cluster nodes. After 2 minutes, WordPress was fully deployed, and I'm making changes in the YAML file to direct the ingress IP to the load balancers. Now, eventually, I can display the default page of the WordPress. Inside the admin workstation at my JKE on-prem, I can use the kubectl tool to display the completed deployments, which is hosted on the GKE on-prem with HPE SimpliVity. This concludes the demo of the Google Cloud's Anthos for the GKE on-prem with HPE SimpliVity. Thank you for your attentions.